Today we will learn RAID, redundancy array independent disk. Basically, as per your network backup requirement or your client requirement, and as a storage of data, you need a backup. As here we use the technology for a backup. It called RAID, redundancy array independent disk. This technology we are used for a backup system, mirroring system, streaming systems. Actually RAID has a three category, level 0, level 1 and level 5. Level 0 it means the streaming without parity bit, level 1 it means the mirroring with parity bit, and level 5 it means the streaming with parity bit. Here RAID configure with the three level. Level 0, in level 0 they require the two hard disk and data store with in two hard disk with single copy. So if any case the one hard disk is fail, you also get some data from other hard disk. In level 1 it means a mirroring with parity bit. So in level 1 we need require the two hard disk and data stored with two copy in two hard disk. It means here we create a mirror image of one hard disk to another hard disk. So in this case one hard disk is fail, you get a total backup from another hard disk. And in level 5 there are required the three hard disk, and here data store with streaming and with the parity bit. It means in case suppose one hard disk is fail, you get a total backup from other two hard disk. Here data store with some matrix calculations. Here in this practical we can configure a RAID with level 0 and level 1. Here in this CBT we perform the level 0 RAID practicals. So here we create two partition with RAID type. Just see in our terminal, first of all we get a partition information with fdisk-l command. You see there are the six partition. Now we create a partition with fd space slash dev slash sda. Here our hard disk is a SATA. Here press N for create a new partition. N, press enter. First of all set a default cylinder and then type a size of partition if you need. Here we create one partition with 100 MB size. Press enter. Now partition is created. Now we create second partition. For that press N, enter, start partition with default cylinder, press enter, then set last cylinder size plus 100 M. Now we create two partition. If you want to get information of partition, just press P, see the partition information. Here two partition are created. Now set a type of partition. For that press T and press enter. Now type a partition number 7, press 7, enter. Now set a partition type. Here we set a partition type FD. FD is the partition type of RAID. FD, press enter. We also set a partition type to 8 number partition, press 8. If you want to see the information of partition, press P. So here two partitions 7 and 8 are created. Now save the procedure. For that press W, press enter. Partition creation procedure is saved. If you want to get a effect, for that run the command part prop. Here you get a effect of your partition changes without rebooting using part prop command. Run the fdisk-l command and see the partition information. Here there are two partition are created, SDA7 and SDA8 with RAID partition type. Now we create the RAID partition MD0. For that we run the following command, MDADM-C, C for create. Here we create the slash dev slash MD0 RAID partition. -A for active, yes. -L for level, 0. -N for number of hard disk, there are 2. Now set a path, C slash dev slash sda in curly bracket set to partition 7 and 8. Press enter. Now MD0 RAID partition is created. The array partition is started. Here MD0 is the array partition of SDA 7 and 8 partition. Now we format the MD0 partition with mkfs.extended3 command. Just see the command in the screen. Partition is formatted. Now we create the one directory, shared directory, and finally mount the MD0 partition on this directory with mount command. The command see on the screen, mount slash dev slash MD0, and then set a mount point share. So here the shared directory is the mount directory of MD0. If you want to mount permanently, just entry in appstep file with vim editor. So open the appstep file that store in etc directory with vim editor and enter the following line. Partition name MD0, mount point share, partition type auto, set the default policy 00, save the file. And if you want to take an effect, run the mount command. Okay, so see the information of mount point set. So finally we create a